Welcome everybody to the SmackDown After Money in the Bank, and what a show we have for you tonight. As the Intercontinental Championship will be on the line as Johnny Gargano defends against Shinsuke Nakamura in a one-on-one match. And also tonight, the new SmackDown Women's Champion Toni Storm will be in action. Also, the SmackDown Tag Team Champions will be in action, and much more on this stacked SmackDown After Money in the Bank. So let's get this show started, ladies and gentlemen. Ladies and gentlemen, it looks like we're going to kick things off with the man who came up short at Money in the Bank last Sunday against the Beast Incarnate, Brock Lesnar, for the WWE Championship, ladies and gentlemen. And we know he's probably not happy with how that ended, not being able to kick out of a second F5. But Roman Reigns here tonight, I mean, you could probably tell he's not going to be happy after what went down. After Brock Lesnar retained and he made a promise to take that championship off of him and give it back to the people, ladies and gentlemen. And tonight, he's coming to the ring, not looking happy, not happy at all. I mean, I can't wait to see what Roman Reigns has to say about what went down last night in that match against Brock Lesnar. I mean, he's come up short against Brock Lesnar multiple times. He's beaten Brock Lesnar multiple times. But last night, it was not enough to take that WWE Championship off of him and give it back to the people, ladies and gentlemen. And tonight, he might be challenging Brock Lesnar once again at Extreme Rules, ladies and gentlemen, because we know he is not done with that. We have a good feeling he won't be done with it, because he is never done with chasing that WWE Championship and Brock Lesnar. So, ladies and gentlemen, we are about to hear what the big dog Roman Reigns has to say about what went down last night. So, ladies and gentlemen, let's take it to the ring, and let's hear what the big dog Roman Reigns has to say. Last Sunday, I was bested by the Beast once again in my career, and he once again left me beaten and battered in the middle of this ring. But everyone here tonight knows that's not enough to stop the big dog. So Brock, get out here and get in this ring so I can take the WWE Championship from you. Whether it's here tonight or on SmackDown or Extreme Rules, I will take the only thing you care about, the WWE Championship. And here comes a man who came up short in the Money in the Bank ladder match, ladies and gentlemen, but it did not affect his singles and his tag team record, ladies and gentlemen, as it was a match that could not end in a pinfall, ladies and gentlemen. And so Matt Riddle is still undefeated on SmackDown, ladies and gentlemen, and I don't know what he's got to say, but apparently he's heard enough of what the big dog had to say, and Matt Riddle might have something to say about what Roman Reigns said and the fact that Roman Reigns lost to Brock Lesnar once again at Money in the Bank. Roman, bro, with all due respect, will you just shut up, bro? You're right about what Brock did to you last Sunday. He left you battered and beaten in this ring, and to be honest, bro, do you really want to put the fans and yourself through that pain once again, Roman? Here's some advice, Roman. Leave Brock to someone that actually stands a chance against Brock. For example, the original bro, Matt Riddle. So how about you and I face each other tonight to see who stands more of a chance against Brock?
Ladies and gentlemen, Elias.
Hello, I am Elias. And as the man who holds the power of the wind in his fist, I've got one question for everybody here tonight. Who wants to walk with Elias? Now, I have been all across the world. I've been to Paris, I've been to Italy, all across Europe, South America, South Africa, you name it, Elias has been there, and it has brought me here tonight. And it seems everywhere I go, no matter what I do, a universal truth follows me. And I am certain that everyone here knows it. It is that WWE stands for...
But would you look at that, ladies and gentlemen, Elias gets eliminated once again by his opponent tonight, Cedric Alexander, as Elias fell short in that Money in the Bank ladder match. Also, not being able to pick up the win, as Ricochet is Mr. Money in the Bank over on Raw, ladies and gentlemen. And now tonight, Elias is going toe-to-toe with Cedric Alexander. But ladies and gentlemen, if that match does become official, we will have Roman Reigns and Matt Riddle for the very first time, 1-on-1 in the middle of the ring in tonight's main event. I mean, honestly, I cannot wait to see if that comes out to play. But ladies and gentlemen, Cedric Alexander is set to take on Elias here tonight on SmackDown Live. And what a match this could be for Cedric Alexander to pick up a win against somebody like Elias. And here we go, ladies and gentlemen. The match begins as the referee rings the bell, and let's see what's going to happen as Elias just takes down Cedric Alexander with that big knee right there, and Cedric Alexander already not looking good as a slap right there and then a punch, and then going for that discus clothesline right there, but Cedric able to get out of it and now on the attack of Elias, ladies and gentlemen. And Cedric Alexander, what's he's looking for right there with a kick to the midsection as Cedric Alexander takes control. And Elias able to get out of the way and then clotheslining Cedric Alexander right there. And here we go. Ladies and gentlemen, with a scoop slam right there to Cedric Alexander. And Cedric Alexander looked to be going great, but a big knee right there to the face of Alexander, ladies and gentlemen. And like I was saying, Cedric Alexander was looking pretty good to kick things off in this match. But now Elias taking control. Now Elias with a kick to the midsection and then another one, and Elias clotheslining Cedric Alexander once again, the second time in the match, and into the cover goes Elias for the win, and not even a one count. Now Elias back on the attack, ladies and gentlemen, with a backbreaker right there into the knee of Elias right there goes Cedric Alexander, and Elias just taking it to Cedric Alexander, apparently not happy with not winning Money in the Bank as Cedric Alexander gets thrown over the top rope. Now the referee begins his count, ladies and gentlemen, as Elias grabs Alexander by the head, looking to throw him into the announce table. Face first goes Alexander, ladies and gentlemen, and Elias looking for a back suplex right there, a backdrop right there by Elias taking down Cedric Alexander as Elias not paying attention to the referee's count as Cedric Alexander able to fight back with a forearm right there and then sent back into the ring by Elias. And Alexander back up to his feet and met right here with a throwing scoop slam right there and into the cover, but a rope break right there as Cedric Alexander's foot was underneath the rope. Elias's anger just getting involved right there and not realizing where Cedric was at, and right here with a snap suplex as the back crashes down into the mat, and Cedric Alexander might not be looking good. And Elias, ladies and gentlemen, I believe Elias just raked the eyes of Cedric Alexander as the referee watched on. And honestly, Elias is either upset about the fact he didn't win last night or the fact that Cedric Alexander interrupted him here tonight. And this is no time, as Cedric Alexander gets hit in the back with a dropkick right there, this is no time to be taunting in the middle of the match when your opponent's still up. Then right there with that knee, I believe that busted open Cedric Alexander, ladies and gentlemen. I don't know who's going to win, but right now, if I had to guess with that elbow drop right there off of the middle rope, if I had to guess, I think Elias is going to pull off this win here tonight. And here we go, ladies and gentlemen, with that scoop slam once again, and Elias, I don't know what's going to happen as Cedric Alexander crawls into the corner, and that might not be a good spot as Elias is waiting for him to get back up. And here we go, ladies and gentlemen, a back elbow by Cedric Alexander, grabbing him by the head, and Cedric Alexander with a scoop, a Russian leg sweep right there by Cedric Alexander, and Alexander back up to his feet, and here we go with another suplex by Elias after he was going for that super kick, I believe, and up to the top rope goes Elias, possibly looking for that elbow drop, and here we go, looking for it, and misses right there, Cedric Alexander gets out of the way, and Elias cannot, I can't believe that Elias was not able to stop that right there. Cedric grabs Elias by the head, looking to drag him into the ropes, ladies and gentlemen. And I don't know what's going to happen as Cedric gets sent into the ropes right there. And right there with a drop down, ladies and gentlemen, a backflip. What in the world? Cedric Alexander, absolutely amazing with that head scissors takedown. And then the kick up, ladies and gentlemen. And here we go. Face first goes Elias. And that could be the end of the match if Cedric Alexander can go for the cover, ladies and gentlemen. And that has got to be it. One. And only a one count as Elias somehow able to survive that with only a one count. How is that even possible? And now Elias, ladies and gentlemen, able to counter with a forearm right there to Cedric Alexander. And Elias, I don't know what he's got to do to defeat Cedric Alexander as he positions him on the ropes, ladies and gentlemen. And over the top rope goes Elias instead of Cedric Alexander. And Elias crashed down hard. And now Cedric Alexander going to the outside as he is on the outside right there with a backhand. And Elias with another hand of a backhand as well. Ladies and gentlemen, no, the drift away on the outside. And that could end up in a count out victory, ladies and gentlemen, if Elias wants that. But Elias apparently not wanting to win by count out, wants to win by pinfall. And here we go, sending Cedric Alexander into the apron. And maybe he does want to win by count out. I don't know what he's even trying to do as Cedric gets sent into the apron once again. And the referee is at the count of six, ladies and gentlemen. And now Elias finally throws Cedric Alexander back into the ring. And back into the ring comes Elias. And Cedric Alexander with an enziguri taking down Elias, ladies and gentlemen. And Cedric Alexander fighting back here with a Northern Lights suplex. Not going into the pinfall, though. And Cedric Alexander looking impressive here tonight against Elias. And here we go, ladies and gentlemen. Elias right there with taking him down right there with that drop toe hold. And here we go into the small package pin, ladies and gentlemen, for the win. 1-2. And Cedric Alexander able to get the short up right there. And Elias is on fire right now. Cedric Alexander needs something, needs momentum here tonight, ladies and gentlemen, as Elias has him by the head, looking to drag him into the corner, face first into the turnbuckle. And right here, Elias just knocking him down right there. And then a beautiful bulldog right there, almost like Chris Jericho used to hit, ladies and gentlemen, for the win. And only a two count right there as Elias able to, as Cedric Alexander able to get the short up right there, screwed that up. I've got to admit that, as Elias went for that big boot, ladies and gentlemen, and going for that super kick with Cedric Alexander, and not enough. Into the corner he goes, ladies and gentlemen, going for that discus clothesline, not able to connect, ladies and gentlemen. And then Cedric Alexander with a kick to the back and just slamming the arm into the mat, ladies and gentlemen. Who is going to win? The fans are absolutely loving this match as Elias able to counter, and a drop kick right there by Elias as he takes down Cedric Alexander. And this match has got to be ending soon, ladies and gentlemen. And up to the middle rope, ladies and gentlemen, Elias looking for something big. And here we go with the elbow drop off of the middle rope, not the top rope, as he missed the top rope one earlier on in the match. And Elias could be looking for the drift away and put away Cedric Alexander here tonight, ladies and gentlemen, as he's dragging him into the middle of the ring. And here we go, ladies and gentlemen, and looking for the drift away is Elias. And here we go, Elias with the drift away as Cedric Alexander is done, ladies and gentlemen. What a match. 1-2-3, and Cedric Alexander cannot pull off the win as Elias with an impressive victory here tonight. Absolutely impressive by Cedric Alexander as well, but Elias picks up the win here tonight, ladies and gentlemen. After missing that elbow right there off the top rope and then face first into the mat, we thought that was it, but Elias somehow able to survive and kick out right there. And here we go, ladies and gentlemen, able to counter was Elias right there, and then I forget what he hit after that, ladies and gentlemen. But then right there with a small package pin, ladies and gentlemen, not enough, as Cedric Alexander survived. And what a match this was, and right there with that bulldog, ladies and gentlemen, and then that set up the end, ladies and gentlemen. I mean, what a match, as that bulldog did set up the end with the drift away. I mean, what a match. And the drifter Elias picks up a big win after losing at Money in the Bank in a couple weeks ago. He defeated Aleister Black in a ladder match. But ladies and gentlemen, Elias is not finished with Cedric Alexander. What an award is Elias taking right there, connecting with that, finally not able to connect with that at all in the match, ladies and gentlemen. And now Elias, what an award is Elias thinking about doing, maybe picking up that guitar, but I don't think he is, ladies and gentlemen, as he goes back on the attack of Cedric Alexander. And what an award is Elias even thinking about doing, grabbing him by the head. I don't know what's going to happen. Sending him into the corner, ladies and gentlemen, and then a clothesline. And then here comes the bulldog once again as he takes down Cedric Alexander, ladies and gentlemen. Poor sportsmanship right here. Poor winner, may I add, ladies and gentlemen. And Elias going up to the middle rope after going up to the long middle rope right there. And then the elbow drop, ladies and gentlemen. And Elias is going to be looking for that drift away once again. Elias, this is definitely unsportsmanlike right here with the drift away. And Elias with the win, but absolutely disrespectful at the end of the match, attacking him after the match. I don't even know what to say other than disrespectful. Now, moving on, ladies and gentlemen, to some tag team action, the SmackDown Tag Team Champions. And ladies and gentlemen, look who's back. It looks like Kofi Kingston making his return here tonight with the New Day, as we were set for some tag team action, as Xavier Woods and Big E are set for tag team action against Ryder and Hawkins, ladies and gentlemen. And Kofi Kingston's back with the pancakes, and I don't even know what to say other than welcome back, Kofi, after being gone for a couple of months. And I mean, after that match with Brock Lesnar, he hasn't been seen until now, ladies and gentlemen. And can I just say, before I move on from that last match, what a disrespectful showing from Elias. Poor sportsman, poor sore loser, may I add, also as well, attacking Cedric Alexander after the match. Just absolutely disrespectful, and I don't know other to say other than that's who Elias is, a disrespectful piece of crap. And here comes Ryder and Hawkins, ladies and gentlemen. And what a tag match this is going to be. I'm a huge fan of Hawkins and Ryder, ladies and gentlemen. But the New Day able to retain against the Revival last night. Not last night, but last Sunday at Money in the Bank, ladies and gentlemen. What a match that was. The Revival putting on a show, but not enough to reclaim the tag team championships, ladies and gentlemen. But tonight, if Ryder and Hawkins can pick up a win against the New Day, against the SmackDown Tag Team Champions, that would definitely give them a SmackDown Tag Team Championship opportunity. Well, it looks like Big E and Zack Ryder are going to kick things off for the respective teams, ladies and gentlemen, as Kofi Kingston on the outside and the match begins. And right there, Big E taking out Zack Ryder right there, just absolutely running through him. And here we go, picking up Zack Ryder right there with that spinning sit-out spine buster, ladies and gentlemen. But only one count right there as Ryder gets his shoulder up. And Zack Ryder, ladies and gentlemen, sending Big E out onto the apron over the top rope. And Zack Ryder just waiting, gaining momentum right there out of the ring, ladies and gentlemen. And right there with that scooping the leg off of the apron back first into the apron as Big E rolling out of it right there into the belly throw, ladies and gentlemen, as the referee is at the count of two. And Big E, ladies and gentlemen, sending Ryder back into the ring, as we know the New Day definitely want to get a win inside of the ring, as Kofi Kingston celebrating his team. As Big E up on the top rope getting punched by Ryder, and then a kick right there getting out of it, and then clotheslining Ryder, as Ryder might need to make a tag very soon. And Big E grabbing Ryder by the head, possibly going to drag him into the corner and get our first tag of the night, ladies and gentlemen. But Ryder fighting out of it, not wanting to get attacked right there in the corner, ladies and gentlemen. And Ryder, what in the world? Ryder face first goes Big E, ladies and gentlemen. And Zack Ryder might have just picked up the win against the SmackDown Tag Team Champions into the cover, ladies and gentlemen. And not even a one count is Big E able to survive that face first move, ladies and gentlemen. And Ryder, what in the world? The Zack attack, ladies and gentlemen, out of nowhere, taking him down. And then a hot tag is made, as here comes Xavier Woods, as Ryder took out Big E, and right there goes down Ryder, ladies and gentlemen, up to the top rope. But a hot tag is made, and here comes Hawkins, ladies and gentlemen, as Xavier Woods looking for a suplex right there, ladies and gentlemen, a snap suplex taking down Hawkins and up to the top rope, ladies and gentlemen. And Woods connects with that elbow drop off the top rope, ladies and gentlemen, for the win, and not even a one count, as Hawkins able to survive, as Kofi Kingston cheering on Xavier Woods. And a punch right there by Hawkins getting out of it right there, and then a knee after Hawkins was going for a spear of some sort or something, and then a knee catching Hawkins in the head, ladies and gentlemen. And right there with an elbow right there, a pullback elbow right there by Xavier Woods, as Ryder's out on the apron, ladies and gentlemen, and sent over the apron goes Hawkins, ladies and gentlemen. And Xavier Woods, what is Xavier Woods looking to do right here with the sunset flip powerbomb on the outside? And Hawkins could be out for good. And sent back into the ring by Woods is Hawkins, ladies and gentlemen, looking for that hot tag, and it is made, as both Hawkins and Ryder has already made a tag right there in this match with a drop kick and Ryder into the cover for the win. And this could be it, but not even a one count, as Woods able to survive, ladies and gentlemen. And Ryder gets countered right there. Why did I say Ryder's? And right here with a drop down, ladies and gentlemen, and then that leapfrog as Xavier Woods with that hip toss arm drag almost right there, and absolutely amazing as Ryder gets sent out onto the apron and Big E into the match finally once again. And here we go right there with that hip toss by Big E into the ring, into the cover goes Big E for the win, and not even a two count as Zack Ryder able to get that shoulder up right there at 1.5. And now Leiter gets countered by Big E once again, and Big E with a clothesline taking down a former Raw Tag Team Champion in Zack Leiter and Curt Hawkins, ladies and gentlemen. And here we go, Big E waiting for Leiter as Leiter sends Big E into the corner, able to counter, ladies and gentlemen. And then a kick right here, and then what in the world is Leiter even thinking about doing right there with a sunset flip, ladies and gentlemen, a sunset flip by Leiter. And into the cover goes Leiter for the win, one, and only a one count as Big E able to survive right there as he gets out at 1.5. And Big E got up first before Zack Ryder with a kick to the midsection, looking for a power bomb of some sort. Here we go, up onto the shoulder right there, and then down with that power bomb, ladies and gentlemen, as Big E able to take control back. And here we go, ladies and gentlemen, Big E right there with that jumping frog splash, his whole weight coming down onto the chest of Zack Ryder for the win, two, and Ryder able to kick out right there at 2.5 as Hawkins tried to break it up. And now Big E grabbing Leiter by the head, probably looking to drag him into the corner, hit the Midnight Express, and put away Leiter and Hawkins, ladies and gentlemen. And that might be exactly what's happening, but no, ladies and gentlemen. We've seen this before right here with the kick to the midsection and then the back crashing into the knee right there. A beautiful move by the SmackDown Tag Team Champions. And Leiter back up to his feet as Woods hits the ropes, ladies and gentlemen. And here we go. Face first goes Zack Leiter, busting him open, ladies and gentlemen. And that could be the end of the match for Hawkins and Leiter for the win. And Zack Leiter somehow able to kick out, ladies and gentlemen, at 2.5. How in the heck did that even happen is my question. As here we go. Big E back into the match, possibly looking to put away Hawkins and Leiter here tonight, ladies and gentlemen, with the Midnight Express, but right there with a knee strike, taking Zack Leiter down, ladies and gentlemen. And back into the match comes Xavier Woods. Beautiful tag team work right here by both Woods and Big E, ladies and gentlemen. I don't know who's going to win, as this has been an impressive match for both teams, ladies and gentlemen, as Leiter throwing Woods into the corner right here, and this could be a tag by the kick to the midsection once again, ladies and gentlemen. And here we go, looking for the boot in the corner. Woo, 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 you know it. And then the big boot right there into the corner as Woods is out cold, ladies and gentlemen. And into the cover goes Zack Leiter. This could be it, ladies and gentlemen. And not even a one count as Woods somehow able to survive and get back up to his feet before Zack Leiter even does. And Leiter with a forearm right there to Woods. And Woods right here throwing Leiter over his shoulders, ladies and gentlemen. I don't know what's going to happen as Xavier Woods grabs him by the head. Might be looking for the Unicorn Stampede as Kofi Kingston watches on, ladies and gentlemen. And here we go, looking for the Unicorn Stampede as Woods right here kicking him multiple times, ladies and gentlemen. Kicking the life out of Zack Leiter. And here comes Big E and the tag. And here we go, kicking the life out of Zack Leiter once again, this time by Big E. And here we go, ladies and gentlemen. Woods kicking Zack Leiter, kicking him into another dimension, it seems like. I mean, absolutely brutal. And here we go, ladies and gentlemen. Big E with a drop kick right there. What a beautiful, beautiful move, ladies and gentlemen. The Unicorn Stampede as Zack Leiter and Curt Hawkins could be minutes away from dying. And the fans are indeed right. This is indeed awesome as Big E able to counter, ladies and gentlemen. And then a headbutt to the back of Zack Leiter and right here just throwing him across the ring like it was absolutely nothing. And Curt Hawkins with a forearm right there after Big E tried to punch him off of the apron to end this match, ladies and gentlemen. And Hawkins off the apron now as Big E just staring him down again. Apparently these two do not like each other right now as Big E just throws him over with a hip toss, ladies and gentlemen. And what is going to happen as Big E grabs Leiter by the head? I mean, this match is going to be over very soon, I believe, if they can hit the midnight hour, ladies and gentlemen. And here we go, the tag is made, and here we go, Leiter up for the big ending. Woods up to the middle rope, ladies and gentlemen, and then the midnight hour connects, ladies and gentlemen. And Leiter and Hawkins has got to be done, ladies and gentlemen, as Hawkins coming into the ring trying to break it up, ladies and gentlemen. But that is match as the New Day win, and then a suplex right there by Big E at the end, saving the New Day's win right there, ladies and gentlemen. What a tag team match, may I add. Absolutely amazing as Leiter and Hawkins finally got a time to shine, ladies and gentlemen. And the fact that they almost put away the New Day on multiple occasions in that match was absolutely impressive, ladies and gentlemen. And what a match that was. I mean, I love tag team action. I love the New Day. And right here, Big E, we thought this could have been it right here with that big jumping frog splash, but it was not, as he went into the cover and Leiter did indeed kick out, ladies and gentlemen, at two. Right there, as you can see, kicking out and Xavier Woods face first went Zack Ryder for the win. We thought that was it, and Ryder survived that at 2.5. Ladies and gentlemen, in the New Day get the win as Kofi Kingston makes his return here tonight ringside with the New Day, because he's got to ease into things after being taken out by Brock Lesnar. But what a match as the SmackDown Tag Team Champions, showing why they beat the Revival, showing why they are the top of the tag team division, and showing why they are the SmackDown Tag Team Champions, as Kofi Kingston makes his return, and I can't wait to see what Kofi Kingston is going to do in his return.